This video is sponsored by Squarespace. What's up guys, Sal here. So smartphone battery technology is pretty good these days. But if there's one thing smartphone lovers will never be able to get enough of, is the promise of better battery life. Wouldn't it be great if our handset lasted 2 or 3 full days of heavy use with just a single charge? What about a whole week? With graphene batteries, this might not be such a pipe dream. But the problem is, graphene batteries are still a distant dream. Although Samsung is rumored to be working on this technology, it would still take years for us to see a graphene battery-powered smartphone. However, the good news is Samsung is preparing to implement another solution that may not be as good as the graphene tech, but would surely help increase the battery capacity significantly without increasing the overall footprint of the battery, and we may see this tech being implemented as soon as the Galaxy S23 Ultra. A reputed South Korean publication, The Elec, reports that Samsung will use a battery technology called stacking that it currently makes advanced electric vehicles batteries with for their smartphones. See, right now smartphone batteries are made using a flat roll method, and one large disadvantage of this method is lithium polarization, which occurs at folds during charging, causing the effective battery materials of the battery to not become fully activated, thus reducing the energy density of the battery. This is not a problem in Samsung's stack design, as there is no folding or rolling involved. The battery components are stacked like in a staircase style arrangement, which allows to package the battery components tighter and achieve a 10% increase in capacity. This means a 5500 mAh battery cell can be put in the Galaxy S23 Ultra with the same overall footprint as the S22 Ultra. Alternatively, they can make the S23 Ultra thinner with a 5000 mAh battery too. Samsung has already set up a manufacturing plant to make these batteries, so hopefully the technology will be ready in time for the Galaxy S23. We also have other information about the S23, but before that, let's talk about the sponsor of this video, Squarespace. Squarespace is a platform that lets you create a website in a web browser without coding and edit it easily thanks to a user-friendly content management system. Three things I like the most about Squarespace are, the templates here are some of the most powerful, yet some of the most simple I've ever used. They're also always getting updated, and also it just gives you peace of mind. You never need to worry about patching or updating a website or installing new plugins. It's all done for you behind the scenes. So go to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/techtalktv or use the coupon code techtalktv to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Back to the video, you see a few days ago we got a report from South Korea that Samsung has decided to use MediaTek's Dimensity 9000 chip for the Galaxy S22 FE as well as the Galaxy S23. Samsung has never used a MediaTek chipset in their flagship phone, so it caught everyone off guard when we saw that report. But a new rumor suggests that it's not happening. This tipster, who has a good track record, mentions that neither the S22 FE nor the S23 will use the MediaTek chipset for now. In fact, he mentions it's not gonna happen at all. This means you'll get Snapdragon or Exynos chipsets depending on the market. Now the good news is Samsung CEO said they'll make the Exynos chipset tailor-made for the Galaxy phones going forward, similar to how Apple makes the A-series chipsets for the iPhones. This will hopefully mean the device will generate less heat and hence less throttling. The battery life should get better too. The main reason the flagship chipset from the past couple of years have had heating problems is due to ARM's architecture. Android chip makers use off-the-shelf ARM designs unaltered to make their chips, whereas Apple closely works with ARM and makes the necessary changes to make it better work on iPhones. Since Samsung has also decided to do the same, let's hope it makes the experience on Samsung phones significantly better. Of course, for all the latest updates on this handset, be sure to subscribe, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.